What did the Lord Jesus Christ give you?
The company to get from who will go for the name who to make a number, if they end up to make a good number.
Says, verily, verily, I say unto you, whoever believes in me, the works that I do will he do also. Greater works than this will he do, because I go back to my Father.
And seeing them in necessity.
What therefore necessitates the coming back of the Lord Jesus Christ when he has laid that promise before you that if you believe in him, you'll do the same work that he does, and you can do the greater work that he has done since he has gone back to the Father. Why is it therefore necessary for him to come back? Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not commit fornication. You should not commit murder. If you comply yourself, it means you are worshiping God, and you see the glory of God shining in you. Whatever you let yourself do, whether it is an evil thing that takes you down to hell, or a good thing that takes you up to heaven, if you continue to submit yourself to such a thing, you are a slave to it.
So the job is in this people in the corner.
So the job is in this people in the corner. Not the voice of God.
Well, two correct, and I will have
Instead of doing that, he definitely answered and said to the tempter, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. You don't have to toy with any word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Even you here in brotherhood, you don't comply with instruction, with the words, with the injunctions, which come out from the mouth of God.
For many brothers who swear, why is why you think of us in Pamikana? I get your own good eyes. I get good numbers. I get good grow in your. I get good in your. The business is a damn bubble. The good grow. Cook send by the world. My good grow. I will own my man.
Being in brotherhood, first being in brotherhood for the past 20 years, what have you derived? What benefits have you taken away from your 20 years here? Been told not to be exasperated, not to steal, not to fornicate, to love every person, and not to do anything which will bring down the glory of God. How many of you have complied to these instructions of God? It does not serve any good purpose for any person to go to the four walls of the university pretending he is studying the scriptures, learning about the word of God. That is the word of God which has been given to you. And the scriptures have truly said, blessed are you when men will revile you and say all manner of things against you falsely for my sake. And you have to rejoice and top up because your reward is great in heaven.
Or move from people to leave this restaurant. Carry it with your me. I said, I'm not sure I remember. Thank you and thank you. Yes, and how when? Oh, Burkas. Bars.
The Bible says, go unto any person who gives drink to his neighbor. How many of you have complied to this injunction? You are giving excuses. Because I am a businessman, I cannot afford to stop giving wine because of my position. Since I'm a traditional ruler, I have to give wine. This means that you don't worship God, you don't honor him, you don't reverence him, and you do not love.
I said,
and God has enjoined that you should not drink any kind of liquor, whether it be strong or soft drink. You have to be a teetotaler, completely refraining yourself from all types of drinks. For now you're giving excuses, I only take a little, or I take soft drink. If you take soft drink or take a little of wine, it means you don't worship God, it means you don't reverence him, it means you don't love him. When the Pharisees went to tempt the Lord Jesus Christ, they asked him whether it was rightful for any person to divorce his wife for whatever reason. What did the Lord Jesus Christ tell
them?
And he said, what is written in the law? From the beginning, God created male and female. And it was said that a woman will leave the house and be attached to the man. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. But now, do you not put asunder? When you divorce your wife, has also committed adultery. Whoever marries two wives does not worship God, does not know God, and does not reverence Him.
So you can get more. Who puts it away? Because you look at more than the dollars. And you know, I'm a little bit of a girl who can put on the offering. We never borrow the cattle, we never borrow the yard, the India, sell us around the moment, Mongo Yabo, Lugan, who I know, Lugan, who went to us, and I'm in class. And in our class, any he could have us. And here in jail, and he can have us. Here in my ass. Here in jail, what's the connection?
All the words of God have to be complied with by all children of God. You don't have to leave some and practice some. The totality of the words of God must be practiced. Even if somebody should come and advise you to help or to steal or to do anything, instead of listening to the flesh, you should listen to the voice of God, which tells you to comply yourself with all injunctions and instructions and exhortations of God.
Dear Barabaru, already tell Jesus. Early,
remember that young man who told the Lord Jesus Christ he would follow him? For then he should be allowed to go and bury his father. What did the Lord Jesus Christ tell? Our Lord Jesus Christ told him, let the dead bury the dead, but you go and proclaim the glory of God. Right now, your thoughts are centered on burials, funeral and memorial ceremonies. That is what you put your thought inside. If it is what you've centered your mind in, it means that you do not worship God and you do not love Him.
If you have a John, I came to Jesus' baptism. You were made of him. And yet, you were a cousin. And John, I got forever, and I'm looking for. What your name would be near? Make your name Lord Jesus. Say, sir. Who's over? Or cousin for? So sit together. And then that person. Go to go. Come back in 14. But everybody know where I'm going for. So then I have it.
That is not
an answer. I go up on an answer. You don't have an answer.
Amen. first lesson came from Gospel according to St. John, chapter 8, verse 47. He that is of God heareth God's word. He therefore heareth not, because ye are not of God. It's not about Jesus Christ.
And that's why whenever somebody starts to practice the word of God, others will proclaim that God has come down. The word of God is like carrying a parcel. When you don't begin to practice the word of God, the content of the parcel cannot be known. But the moment you begin to practice the word of God, the ropes are loosened and the word of God will begin to spark out. And whatever was the content of the parcel will be seen by people. It is clearly stated in the Bible that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And in Him was everything created. Life came from Him. Life came from Him. And without Him, there was nothing made that was made. I want you to mention any particular point in time when the Word departed from the world. Even when the world was born and without form, the world was still in existence. And who is this world? This world is God. Even the blind, even a sinner, a murderer, a highway robber, he's sitting down and he's hearing the stealer's bond voice. The voice is telling him he should not steal, he should not continue to murder, and he should not commit any act of sin. Who is speaking this word and who is this word? When then do you think, at what point in time do you think the word had departed from the earth?
He called me. 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 He called me.
It is emphasized. The word was with God. See, the word is with you. Are you not God? Afterwards, you begin to argue that man can never be God. Human being cannot be God. Who can be God then? And the Bible asks, what does the righteousness tell
you?
Our righteousness says, who will ascend into heaven and bring down Christ? Or who will descend into the Hades or unto the depth to bring him up here? And what does the righteousness tell you? That the word is nearer to you than your tongue to your mouth. That word is in your heart, the word of faith that we preach. And we will not argue that the word is not with you.
And it goes
and who is this word? This word is God. And it said he is in this world, but the worldly people do not know him. And it continues to say that he is walking, so present throughout the world, every second, every minute, every hour. But the people of the world do not know him.
The people know the same.
And God is instructing you, do not steal, do not fornicate, do not beat up any person, do not hurt any person. He's giving you this instruction, and you are hearing the still small voice every minute, every second, every hour. And you refuse to keep these instructions. Afterwards, you say you are worshiping the true God. What is that true God you worship? What did the Lord Jesus Christ tell you?
The captain of the Roman who will go for the Nyan, who took a number, if they are not going to put that down, they have no
blessing. Says, verily, verily, I say unto you, whoever believes in me, the works that I do will he do also. Greater works than this will he do, because I go back to my Father.
And seeing then the necessity, they can do it to Jesus, to kill and get out of it. And yet, for what he never had a big crime, can I not do my own? Who put the energy to Jesus? I told him to kill her for Yanam to my own. Who never did not do it to Jesus?
What therefore does this text, the coming back of the Lord Jesus Christ, when he has laid that promise before you, that if you believe in him, you'll do the same work that he does, and you can do the greater work that he has done since he has gone back to the Father. Why is it therefore necessary for him to come back? Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not commit fornication. You should not commit murder. If you comply yourself, it means you are worshiping God. And you see the glory of God shining in you.
Thank you. What you like to hear from your dear mother? You're really young, and then I'll have your person on the back. You didn't go around with your son. I will love you.
Whatever you let yourself do, whether it is an evil thing that takes you down to hell, or a good thing that takes you up to heaven, if you continue to submit yourself to such a thing, you are a slave to it.
So the job is in this people in the
perfect the law and the prophets. And that is why he founded a very good foundation.